Hello there, fellow Bandhug users. Frank here. This is an instructional video on how to deal with the current synchronization issue. I'm going to give instructions on how you can execute a workaround in order to get your tracks all aligned with each other. But first, a few caveats here. Number one, this workaround or fix, as you may call it, will only work in cases where tracks are ahead of the backing track. There is a procedure on how to deal with cases where tracks are behind the backing track, but that's another story. So in this video, we are only going to talk about cases where tracks are ahead of the backing track. Number two, unless you have clairvoyance, ESP, or have a high midichlorian count and are strong with the force, you will need general knowledge with a DAW in order to determine your correction factor, compensation factor, or offset value in order to align your tracks. I use GarageBand to do this. It's very simple, and if I can do this, anyone can do this. Number three, very important that once you determine your offset factor or your correction factor, enter the numbers exactly as you see them in GarageBand into the Bandhug platform, and I'll demonstrate how this is done. So let's go to Bandhug. So here we are in Bandhug. I have created a test collab. Song should actually be recognizable to most rock and roll fans. So let's hear how it sounds as is, and you will notice that my playing is not in sync with the backing track.
1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Okay, I think it's very obvious that my track is not in sync with the backing track. So let's go into GarageBand and see what we can do. Just in case you do not know how to download the backing track or your guitar vocal track, while you're in studio, you will see three dots underneath the video of the respective track. Just click it and you'll see a download option. So I'm going to download the backing track and the guitar track and import it into GarageBand. So here we are in GarageBand. So the first thing you want to do is make sure that on the display counter at the top, you set it to time. So I've imported the backing track and the guitar track into GarageBand. The backing track is at the top here, and the guitar track is on the bottom here. So let's listen to each one individually. Let's listen to the backing track first.
1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4.
All right, that sounds pretty good. Now let's listen to the guitar track by itself. All right, the guitar track sounds all okay as well. Let's listen to them both, and you'll notice how the guitar track is not in sync with the backing track.
1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Very obvious that the guitar track is coming in ahead of the backing track. So let's take a look at the waveforms of the backing track and the guitar track and see what we can do. Let's listen to the backing track again to get a recognizable part when the guitar track comes in. Or when the guitar part comes in of the backing track, sorry.
1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4.
All right. So if you look at this part of the backing track, that's where the guitar comes in. So that's the beat or the recognizable waveform, which you can use as a bass reference in order to align your out of sync track. We've already established that over here in the backing track, in the guitar track, that's where the guitar comes in. So slide it over in order to match. You can also use the zoom function here for a bit more precision. So let's listen to it now that it appears to be lined up.
1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Not bad, but we're probably dealing with an issue where I'm not playing very well, so we'll just do a tiny adjustment somewhere to get the beats to match. Let's look at this section here. You can see here, the waveform here represents a major beat. Let's move my guitar, slide it ever so slightly to match that of the backing track, and let's listen again, see if it sounds any better.
1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Okay, I think that sounds pretty good. You get the idea. I can fine-tune it by sliding it more precisely to get a perfect match, but you get the idea. Once you've determined that you're happy with how the track is aligned, what you do next is take a look at the backing track with respect to your out-of-sync track. You'll notice that we had to move it over to the right so that it comes in a bit later than as is. And what you have to do now is determine the actual value of your out-of-sync track. So what we got here, I'm actually starting at 0000.082. You have to remember that number and enter that into BandHug. Okay, so you see here once again 00:00.802. You have to enter that into BandHug. So let's do that. So here we are in studio in BandHug. Let's enter that value into the out of sync track. So it was 00.802. Then click outside of the track and you'll see it says time change successfully. Now let's publish it and listen to it again. Alright, we've republished the collab with the entry obtained from GarageBand. Let's listen to it now.
1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Okay, a lot better. We hit pay dirt. So this is the general approach on how you can deal with sync issues where instrumental vocal tracks are ahead of the backing track. Hope this helps.